The last time I was with SK was in 2014 with in EULCS actually, and that was obviously a very, very different time. The scene wasn't as big as it is now, the esports scene. I was a very young player. I was like 17 years old, and I didn't really know what was going on. But now I'm back in LEC, and I'm back with SK Gaming, I think 6 years later. And obviously I'm a completely different person. I've experienced a lot of things, and now I'm here obviously in a new role as a head coach. And that's, to me, that's just funny. That's really, really funny, because I came in as a complete rookie with a bunch of veterans all the way back in the day, and now I'm kind of, you know, the driving force for SK.
So my personal perception of the spring split was obviously it didn't go too well, right? We had a lot of, I won't even say ups and downs, because it was mostly downs, right? So we set ourselves goals, and our goal in the spring split was to reach playoffs, and we didn't reach it. So it was, the whole split kind of was a failure in that sense.
But my impression of the team was that it needed a lot of change. I felt that there was a lack of individual skill, to be honest, in certain roles. I made changes not only, you know, within the actual roster of the team, I also made changes in the staff, and Jesse was someone I'd worked with many, many times in my career. So I knew exactly what his qualities were, and I knew that that was a very good fit for this team.
So when I came into the team, I did not have the highest expectations. And I quickly got the idea that these guys didn't really know how to win. They didn't really know how to approach being in a team, and how to make a team into a winning team, and how to become the best individuals they could be themselves. So I kind of just did what I always do. I come in and I just make sure that they all know what it takes, and basically just make them understand how much work they need to put in. And then from there, I just try to make them as good individuals as possible.
And SK, I cannot believe it.
They are chunking through those towers. They have done it.
The knockoff, and here we go. Where were you when SK Gaming took down Origin?
My world swap happened after the spring split, right? But obviously, I already thought about swapping before I took the decision. It was not like a 1 week deciding thingy where I'm like, oh, maybe I could swap the swap. Okay, yeah, let's do it. It was obviously a longer thingy. Like, actually, always in my career as a mid laner, I always thought that one day I will swap the top lane, because always the champions that I enjoyed the most in mid lane, they got nerfed and then or changed and went into top lane, like Aatrox, for example. So it was a longer thinking process.
Obviously, I had a lot of conversations with Yannick when I first joined. You know, he told me of his intention to swap. He thinks it could be good, and I said, I believe that it can be, because his champion pool in mid lane was very bruiser-centric. Also, I think the strengths in his gameplay were, rather than forcibly putting someone into an uncomfortable position, he was very good at creating space for others, and I think the times he shined the most. I transparently spoke to him. I said, okay, look, I'm not just going to give you your spot in top lane in this team. You have to show me you have what it takes this offseason. And what he did was he structured his practice in offseason unbelievably well, you know, one day playing tanks, one day playing carries, one day playing range tops. So, you know, from the get-go, he was diversifying his champion pool. You know, his commitment to earning his spot on this team was exceptional. And, you know, I wanted to channel that passion and that focus into this team, because I think when you have players like that in your environment, it can really help you motivate others as well. You know, I love hardworking players. It's no secret. It's something I built most of my successful teams off. And, you know, not only that, you know, he clearly has the talent, and he's shown that this split, right? That, you know, he is able to play that way, and he's constantly growing as a top laner. So, you know, I couldn't ask for anything more, because everything I asked him to do, he did. Whether that was in the off season or throughout the season, or whether Jesse had an expectation from him, or whether Paul, our assistant coach, had an expectation, he was professional and exemplary in that way. So I couldn't ask for anything more.
And one, Gen X in his fourth game as a top laner on this stage is tearing through Misfits.
Overall, the both splits together had a lot of ups and downs and some hard setbacks and also some lucky moments, I would say. I got a lot of experience from it as a player, not only from the playing the game side, but also from the mental side. I think I learned how to accept things that happen in game and are not really changeable. And other than that, I think I've became a better teammate and I'm able to cheer my teammates. Like what I always used to do as a player is that I'm like the funny guy, I cheer my teammates up. But it was always really hard for me to do it when the times were not looking so great. And I think I learned how to remain positive mindset, even though the present time is not looking the best. Like if you are on a 3-game lose streak or something, or scrims are going really bad, I still find myself, my inner positivity, and try to bring it to others. And I think that's a really important thing that I learned this year, how to use it effectively.
I would say my personal challenges when it comes to coaching in general is always the hardest part, which is dealing with different personalities and understanding people in general, and understanding how they receive feedback and just in general how to communicate with different individuals. Because I did have individuals on this team that I had never experienced before. Like I'd never experienced working with that type of personality. And that was a great learning experience for me. I don't think there were any like struggles really. I just think that as any other experience, it was a great learning experience.
For me, Summer Split was a really big challenge, not only as a person, also as a player. Like as a player, because I was swapping. So I had to like, besides the fact of being stressed because we need to perform as a team, I also had the stress of performing as a player. It was really challenging, but also in the same regard gave me a lot of motivation. And as a player, it was that we were ninth last place and I really don't want to like be low place again, and I really don't want to miss playoffs. So I had to work really hard. In the end, we actually managed to get to playoffs. We managed to end, I think, fourth or fifth in the regular split, which is like pretty nice if you ask me, so I'm really happy with that. But then in the playoffs we lost to Schalke. It wasn't the greatest feeling, right? But overall I would say the split was successful.
It's over. Well, obviously we had less time to prepare for the split. When I say that, I mean we didn't have a spring split behind us with the same roster, right? We had to move a player to another role and then pick up a new player who was a rookie and then try and achieve playoffs with a roster like that, you know? Actually, with a lot of teams in general, what you'll find is in spring split, they'll find an identity, like a comfort in their play style. I think that is something that you need spring split to develop, and that's where we were behind other teams. We were constantly kind of playing catch up in the sense that, okay, we actually have to find our identity and channel it. And that's also maybe why we were a little less versatile than other teams, right? So, you know, that was probably the biggest challenge we had this split, was, you know, creating that identity. And once we did, we were obviously winning lots of games and, you know, we still made playoffs in light of that. So, we came super close to making Worlds, and honestly, I'm pretty sad we didn't, because I thought we were definitely good enough. You know, we had a really good endings the split. We had a really good standing going into the end of the split. I don't think we lived up to our potential, because we didn't have the time necessary to do that like other teams in the league did.
Schalke beat SK at every stage of the way, through draft, through playmaking, through team fighting, and through ABBA freaking Dog Aid.
And of course, spare a thought for SK Gaming. It was a respectable run, I think, until today. I think placing fifth in the regular season, watching Trick find some form again, some impressive moments from Gen X and Zazie, and frankly, Crownshot having maybe the best split of his career.
So when it comes to a loss, it definitely depends on what type of loss it is and when. If I know that we have a game right after or potentially the day after that matters a lot, I will immediately just detach myself from the situation and not feel as emotional and just try my best to make them understand that what happened, you know, that's a part of the process and that we just need to be able to move on and play as good as possible, perhaps the next day or the next game, because I feel like that's my responsibility. Like the guy's always going to look towards me and in terms of setting the tone and in terms of just, you know, having someone to look towards, I guess. But if I don't feel the need to be that, I'm also going to be emotional and I'm always going to be incredibly frustrated, incredibly sad about losing. So there are definitely moments where I choose to feel and moments where I choose to be, you know, someone the guys can lean on.
And like, this is a thing I have in my whole career as a player. Every time I fail somewhere, the next year I want to make it better. And so far I always made it better. So it was the same with your Masters. Like one time I failed at your Masters play-ins and then I went to your Masters finals. Then I went to LEC, I went 9th place. Now I went into playoffs. So next year I want to go further than 6th place in playoffs.
SK Gaming is an organization with a long, long history in many different games and a long history of winning, you know, including League of Legends in the early seasons as well. It's an organization that I have a deep connection to, obviously because it was my first full-time opportunity in esports. So, you know, I think I have a bit of extra personal motivation there to get this organization back to where it should be. And I'd like to think that, you know, we are definitely one of the more progressive organizations when it comes to, you know, looking after our players. And, you know, we strive to get SK Gaming back to that level that it should be at. So, you know, that's my goal going into next year, is to try and, you know, crack back into the top three initially. I think spring split again, you know, we need some time to develop and look at like the new meta as well. And then, you know, summer have a real crack at Worlds.
So first of all, I want to say thank you to the fans, regardless of what happened in spring split. I just want you to believe in me and as a coach and believe in Joe as a manager and SK as an organization, that we will do whatever it takes to win. I'm personally always just going to try my absolute best. I've always done that as a player. I've always done that as a coach. There's never been a time where I had any other motive. I'm always going to make my players the best possible. I'm going to try to make them look as good as possible. And next year is no different. Next year, I want to achieve a lot more than just making playoffs. And I want to continue making the players I work with the best players in their roles and the best players they can be.
To the fans, I could feel that this split, there was a lot more interaction between me and the fans. I got a lot more comments under my stuff and it was nice to see that there's actually a lot of people that cheer for me if I do well. So I hope that for next year I can give you even better stuff, that you will keep cheering for me.
You know, I definitely want to take a moment to thank you. All of the fans who stuck with us this split, you know, all the memes, all the Crowny memes as well. But personally as well, for those SK fans who are really old school and, you know, supported me back when I was in SK and all the kind of turbulent times that I've had in between, I was definitely humbled by the experience. And I spoke to a lot of people, you know, kind of internal in esports and external as well. And, you know, I'm very thankful for the support that they've given me, because, you know, it made me realize, you know, what kind of an opportunity I had for myself as well. And, you know, I'm not going to allow myself to disappoint other people again. And yeah, I'm just thankful for the opportunity that I was given by SK, and, you know, all the people who have supported me through that. So, yeah.